When was the last time you restarted your Android smartphone or tablet? I understand that rebooting your device regularly isn't something that most people are taught to do, but it can be incredibly helpful for a number of reasons. So today in this video, I'll quickly go over a few ways that you can reboot your device, but then I'll go into detail on 5 different reasons why you want to do this fairly often. Firstly, many of you can bring up the power menu by pressing and holding on the power button for a second or two. You should then see a restart or reboot option somewhere in this menu. So tap on it and you will initiate the process. Some of you, however, we'll have this side key mapped to some AI assistant feature. I know there are a few OEMs that set it up this way by default, so if you are unable to access the power menu using the side key button, then instead you'll want to swipe down from the top of the screen twice. This will expand your quick settings panel. And you should then be able to find a power icon somewhere on this screen. The location will be different depending on if your device is from Google, Xiaomi, or even Samsung. But once you tap on that power icon, that will bring up the power menu where you can then tap on that restart button to reboot your device. Then you'll want to wait for the smartphone or tablet to complete that reboot process. Now, if your phone is unresponsive and you cannot access the power menu at all, you can sometimes force the device to power off by pressing and holding the power button for about 10 to 15 seconds. There are some devices, like the Galaxy S series, which require you to press and hold the power button and the volume down button for 10 to 15 seconds. So if you cannot get to the power menu at all, you may want to try that method instead. Now you may be wondering, what are the advantages of rebooting your Android smartphone so often? This can seem especially unneeded when you are under the impression that your device is running just fine. So the first thing that I'll mention here is that both the NSA as well as the FBI recommend everyone restart their smartphone at least once per week. This can help to protect against zero-click exploits while also mitigating the threat of spear phishing attacks. The suggestion isn't going to block all of these types of security threats from happening, so you will still want to be vigilant about what links you tap on and which files you download. But many of the malware that goes around are not programmed to, or they're not allowed to, reload on the reboot. Another big reason you want to consistently reboot your Android smartphone or tablet is to improve the performance of your device. Those of you with a low-end or mid-range smartphone will find this tip to be more helpful than others. But there are bound to be memory leaks within the firmware itself, or simply with the apps or games that you have installed. Granted, Android is good about managing the RAM for you, so that when it starts to get full, things will be removed so that there is more room for the new app that you'll launch next. But that in and of itself requires the firmware to perform those tasks in the background, many times when it isn't even needed, so you can help to stop those memory leaks from building up so frequently by rebooting your device every few days to once per week. There will even be some that see a benefit from doing this daily. Wiping the cache partition used to be a popular troubleshooting step for those who are experiencing random issues with an application or with Android as a whole. However, modern Android devices no longer use this partition within the file system. And instead, this cache data is cleared out when the smartphone or tablet is restarted. This cache data can add up as well. So instead of using those shady cleaner apps that promise to make your device run faster, it's almost always a better idea to simply restart your Android device so that all of that cache data can be cleared out. Even though this won't usually free up a massive amount of storage, it will prevent the operating system from needing to manage the limited cached space that you currently have. If you have noticed an application is no longer functioning the way it should, maybe you see it force closing or glitching when you attempt to use it, then a quick reboot may be all that is needed to fix the issue. The same can be said about broken services that run in the background, like being unable to pair your Bluetooth device with Android, or being unable to update applications from the Google Play Store. Restarting your Android smartphone or tablet could be what is needed to get it back up and running properly. The last thing that I want to point out has to do with over-the-air updates. These firmware updates are completed after the device has been turned off and back on again. Often, you will see these new updates add additional features to your smartphone, which may be why you aren't seeing some new feature that is being shared online or via a friend or family member. But these updates also come with important security patches that help to keep your device more secure. Once these updates are ready to be completed, you are typically given a notification as a reminder. But I know there are lots of people who will just swipe that notification away instead of following through and completing the install. So getting into the habit of rebooting your device is a good way to make sure that it stays up to date. As you can see, there are many reasons why one would want to restart their Android smartphone or tablet on a regular basis. If you have found it difficult to be consistent with this, there are some OEMs who include an auto restart feature within the settings application, and you can set it up so that it will automatically be done for you. For everyone else, it can be a good idea to set a daily or weekly reminder to turn off the phone and turn it back on again at a time when you know you aren't going to be very busy. Getting into the habit of doing this right as you're getting ready for bed is something that I've been trying to do myself. And before I end this video, please remember to like it while also subscribing to the channel for more Android content like this.